Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel. Now in this tutorial, I will reveal the three topmost liked shortcuts in Xcode 10, well, in my opinion. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. Okay, now what I have done till now is just basically create a brand new project. So that is all I have added here. And just some dummy text here with label, a view, and with some layer setup for my view. And with these three, I will show you the three top most liked shortcuts that I basically use all of the time, and they are really cool, and most probably you don't know them already. Okay, so the first one is this Command, Alt, and the curly braces. So we can use both curly braces here. Now, this is kind of a not well known shortcut, and let me show you how you can use it. So what we have here is a label, and yeah, maybe you want to customize it and you want to create a lazy variable here for that label. So what you kind of do here is type in lazy var, set the name as the same as the label, so UI label equals, and so now we just start typing in label. So let a label equals UI label, but you know, this line is the same as this one and this is already in there. So what I usually do is when I get to this point, so I have added all of these two curly braces, so let me go there, I just simply go down here and that is just it. I'm selecting this line only and I hold down Command Alt and just use the curly braces, so the opening curly braces, and it's moving it all the way up. And of course we could move that down with the ending curly braces. So let me just go back, and if we wanted to, we could just simply select these two lines too, and again Command Alt, and it is moving it all the way up. Okay, well that is it. Let me just return our label, so that is how I just finish this lazy variable up. Okay, so that is Command Alt and curly braces. Next up, we have Control I. Well, most probably you are going to search Stack Overflow for new code, and yeah, it might be indented, but it might not be indented. And this is how an unindented lines of cones look like basically when you just simply copy and paste or just copy and paste from another project. So yeah, you could just go here and add with tabs maybe, but yeah, that is kind of the longest way, and maybe you have a lot more lines than I do have here. So what you can use is Control I. So let me just select all of these, or you could just do this. So it doesn't really matter to start off at the beginning and end at the end of the line. Just select all of these and hit Control I. And it is indented automatically, or rather yet auto magically. Okay, so that is the second tip that you can use in Xcode 10. Now let's move on to today's third and last tip. And it is Alt, so just hold down Alt and drag with your mouse. Now, what does this do? Well, it's kind of a useful trick when you again copy and paste, but in this case, I just add it here, self.myview layer corner radius. So I'm grabbing the real my view from here. So that's that. And I just thought that, okay, but I could just live with this without this self. So we are accessing my view the same way, with or without a self. Maybe I had another my view and I just wanted to specifically have this accessed with a self. But I don't need it anymore. So what I could do is just go on there and delete each and every one, but that is not the way I'm going to do this. Maybe you have a lot more lines. I'm just going to use Alt and just drag with my mouse and to select all of these cells. So let's click on Alt now. So I'm just selecting Alt. And as you can see, we can select anything that we want here. And now I'm just hitting backspace and voila, everything of the cells have been removed just like that. Now that is the final tip for today. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell, because even if you subscribe, you might not get the latest video on your feed. So go ahead and do hit that notification bell. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.